Hello everyone, this is Noble John. Welcome to another episode of ARK Survival Evolved Single Player. Today, we are recovering. Things have not gone as we would like them to go. It's still just, okay, that's still there. That's still good. Alright, you're doing good. Your inventory's fine. What did I just grab? T-Rex kibble. So, the last episode won't actually air. Because as soon as we were done recording, we hit the button to stop. It didn't stop. It did that thing again. I think I talked about it in a previous episode where it just kind of, I don't know, it just keeps saying stopping or stop recording and has an ellipses afterwards. Anytime I see the ellipses, I get nervous because the ellipses seem to indicate that it's trying to stop recording, but it's not stopping. And it just keeps going and going and going. We were at about 4 hours worth of footage that was going to be edited down to about half an hour. There was a lot of stuff that just took a lot of time. So yeah, it wasn't going to be that long of an episode. Oh, and ARK's got glitches. We'll talk about that in a minute too. But yeah, it wouldn't stop recording the episode, so I had to quit my recording software, OBS. And in quitting the software, it lost the file. It's all gone. We have a T-Rex here. Her name is Lady. She's 159, nearly ready to be leveled up again. Her health isn't too good because she was at 4,400. We've raised her up to 10,000. Trying to get her melee up to 1,000 as well. But yeah, we just tamed her out in what would have been the last episode. Remember that time when we had this Bronto over here and the same thing happened? Yeah, so we lost all that footage, but we have a new T-Rex. And I need to give her a saddle and stuff like that too, so that we can take her out and level her up. We also have this new sabertooth named Selena, because she is a cat woman. Get it? Of course you do. So I took that, this unfortunate happening as a sign that perhaps I'm getting a little bit too ambitious in my episodes. Perhaps I have too lofty goals. My goals are too lofty. And what I need to do is to take it easy every now and then and not try to do something that's going to take me 4 hours to do in recording. I'll give you some more melee. Yeah, we also have all these raptors. So a lot has happened. We've got four female raptors now, all of them named Tina, of course. We have this new guy here, Killer, because, well, he wandered into our base, just like a bunch of other stuff is done, and we're kind of upset with that. So I just punched him out, tamed him, and now we have a new guy here. Let me go find, oh, my RG's on this side. Sorry if it seems like I'm a little bit scatterbrained. There's just so much that has happened since the last time we were here, and it's all disappeared. So I'm just kind of giving you a summation. We've tested out putting out a foundation over in this direction to see if we can put up a wall and see if that would prevent things from coming in. And while we were doing that, a Carbonemus right over here wandered into our base. You can see it's not mine because it keeps wandering around trying to get out from between those two dinosaurs. But yeah, that guy wandered in. The dodo over there, there's a dodo right next to me apparently too. He must have wandered in from that side because we haven't put a wall up there yet. But yeah, so so we've been trying to stop those things from coming into our base. It doesn't bother me if there's a flyer that comes into our base because they can go over the walls. And it's unfortunate. We can't prevent that because the only thing we could do is put up a turret. And I don't yet have Plant Species X seeds, so I can't do the plant turret. And I don't really want to do enough bullets to do automated turrets as well. So yeah, we have no turrets. All we have is walls. And we want our walls to prevent dinosaurs from just wandering into our base because they get in our way a lot, and we don't really like that. So that's what we've been trying to do, is build that wall. And I just decided to take a break from that. So we decided that we wanted to go up north and try to look for a T-Rex to tame, a high-level T-Rex, because we had Pulmonous Scorpius eggs. We had something like 30 Pulmonous Scorpius eggs, so we wanted to gather some, we made some kibble, 20 kibble to be precise, and then we went out looking for a high-level T-Rex, and we wandered all over the island. Let me actually pull up my map. There we go. Now you can see. We flew up over in this direction, and we went all around inside of the redwood forest here, and we found a really cool area over here that I highly recommend you go and check out. Over in this region, there were 4 Titanosauruses all in the same spot. I could see them all at the same time. So yeah, wherever I may have read that there was only supposed to be 3 at one time, that's completely wrong, because I know there's one here. There are 2 in this area. There are 4 over here. There are 2 over here. There are 3 over here. And there are 2 over here. Those are just the ones I found so far. And I haven't tried to kill them, so I know that they still exist. But yeah, we went all over the island looking through, like, up in this river area. It was really, really, really cool area. I highly recommend exploring that as well. And we came up on this mountain, and we came down into this valley in this little area here where there's a little pond, little lake inland, and there was a... Oh, actually, it's probably right here. What's this then? Huh. I don't know what that is, if that's the little lake. But we went over there, and there was no good T-Rexes in any of this area. So we eventually just went to Carno Island and circled until we found... Whoops. Lady. Lady, I think, was a 100, a level 100. We were trying to look for one that was a level 120, of course, because that would be in a perfect tame. We're just going to walk around on our RG like this. But we did find a 100, and with kibble, we were able to get her up to, I think it was 149? What level are you at now? Oh, backspace is enabled. 159, okay. So all her leveling that she's done so far has been without me riding her, because I still don't have the engram? Yeah. 225 right now. Oh man, I'm almost at level 79. That's pretty cool. I'm gonna kill a couple more alpha raptors and alpha carnos and maybe some alpha rexes. We should get that. Let's see how much it costs to do a rex saddle. 20? Let's do it. Because we want a rider. Is this the rex one? No, it's an argentivus one. Where's the rex one? Oh, it's probably inside of a smithy or something. Let's go check the smithy. Oops, looks like my gamma's up. Yeah, Gamma doesn't need to be up inside because we have our lovely lamps now. It's bright in here during the day and the night. Hard to tell what time of day it is because of that. Where? Diplodocus, Ankylo, Carno, Bronto, Rex. Oh, we can already make one. What do we need? 380 fiber? We have like 3,000 fiber. Not fiber, hide. 200 fiber, 50 metal ingots. We are actually really low on metal ingots. We're going to have to go and make some of those. All right, let's do this. We want to... No, what do you... Oh, yeah, I picked... That's right. I finally made us a bookshelf where we put all of our blueprints. Because we've gathered so much chitin and keratin that I thought it was time to just put it in its separate chest. So this is all a bunch of items and stuff that we can use and carry that we're not using. This is the rare one still. And you can see it's a lot less stuff than it used to be. The rest I have not changed. Narcotics is nearly full. So this thing can carry, you know, 72 more and then 200 more. So 272 and it is full. And we have more than that much remaining. You saw there was 250 on my RG. Yeah, inside of Misk. And yeah, we are. So many things not in this episode. One of the things that I tried to show you is how to create a folder. And you create it thusly. And you name it Bob, or whatever you want to call it. And it makes the folder. And I don't think that there's a way to actually remove the folder. Take all from folder, take all from inventory. Take all from inventory. Can I just push delete? Oh, you can push delete. So I just got a bunch of miscellaneous stuff in here, including 250 narcotics and some extra trank darts. In case I decide to tame something, here is my fur armor, in case I go anywhere cold. hey, why don't you hold on to this? Then yeah, she's doing really well. Movement speed is at 135%. It goes up by 2.5% every time you level it. So yeah, you can tell I've done it quite a few times to be at 135. Because it started at 100%. 130. We need to level you up too, but I don't have a saddle for you. And I don't really want to make a saddle for you right now. I'd rather see if we can find one. The T-Rex, on the other hand, needs a saddle. We have done it. I don't know what episode this is. Are we stuck? No, we're not stuck. Alright, now we're free. I need food. We have done it. We have claimed ourselves a Rex. We are riding our Rex. Can we eat you? Level 4 Parasaur. Sorry, Bubble Yums. In case any of you are watching don't know who Bubble Yums is, she's one of the people on staff at Studio Wildcard, I think is what it's called. The company that makes ARK. Is she like the community manager? I'm not sure what her position is right now, but she loves Parasaurs. Want to see something fun? Oh, that's so cool. Hold on. What are you? You are a level 12 packy female. Goodbye. That didn't take long. Hey, Parasaur. Oh, this is so much fun. We're actually just going to cut across the mountain this way. Just to go straight across to the other side. I actually want to see if there's any metal nodes up here. Because we did have a problem with metal spawning. Oh, it looks like they're all back. I see three right there. Yep, there's another one right up there. Finally, we were running low on metal and it wasn't spawning on this place anymore. Diplodocus. Oh, here, regain your stamp. I don't care. I need to refill my canteen anyway. Oh yeah, sorry. How long does it take you to refill your stam? It's currently at zero. Oh. It takes an eternity. It's not even a third done. How much meat do you have? You're doing pretty good for meat. You're eating it like crazy though. Look at your stamina. Where is it? Oh, it's full now. Okay. Kill the Diplodocus. I can't see a thing. It's nudging me. Yeah. Yeah. I did it. There's a really fun trick with dinosaurs if you jump off of a cliff. Just chop down that tree and leveled up. Cool. If you jump off of a cliff on a dinosaur and you think it's going to take a lot of damage because you saw it was falling for quite a while and I didn't want to have to... Man, stupid fog. I didn't want to have to spend a lot of time force-feeding it meat in order to get all its energy back. So right at the last second, if you jump, you can see if I'm currently no longer riding my dinosaur, but I'm in the saddle. Because when I jump off a T-Rex, I don't fall off the T-Rex. Hello, raptors. I can't see a thing. It's raining. Foggy. This river isn't even deep enough for you not to worry about it. Get a stego. So yeah, if you jump off of them, you'll still be inside of the saddle, and your dinosaurs do not take fall damage when they hit the bottom. So your best bet is actually... Oh, there wasn't even a dinosaur there. It was just a glitch. Yeah, it just does that every time I go by a tree. Fixes the camera. So my T-Rex doesn't take fall damage, and I didn't take the brunt of the fall damage either, because I didn't fall very far. 667. Ooh. What level are you? I like your colors. Level 4. Yeah, we're not going to worry about you. Let's see if we can kill you. Yep, even balled up, we still got you. Got it before it landed in the water, I think. Maybe we didn't. Oh well. What level are you, Packy? 60, that was actually pretty high. We're not too worried about it. We can just run all we want. But yeah, we went up north. We tamed ourselves a T-Rex, and I really wanted to show you guys a really high-level Rex. Apparently, my recording software thought that it would be a better idea if I just did something like this. Wandered around and killed a lot of stuff with you. What level are you? I don't want to kill you if you're a high level. What level are you? 8? If you're level 8, I don't have any qualms about killing you. Bye, level 8. You just gave me a lot of garbage. I think we're going to get up to 1,000 melee damage. Is that a terror bird? It is a terror bird. There are terror birds closer to my base than they used to be. So we're going to be less ambitious. I just run around the island killing stuff. Kind of give you guys an on-foot tour of this side of the map. I don't know if you guys quite know where I'm at. I mean, if you've played the game, you hopefully do. Down that way, I had an episode where I was flying my Argentavis. Yeah, that was the episode where I was leveling it up. And I went flying down that way doing the comparison of ARK to chess. Saying I was in the end game now. And down that way is where I tamed out the two Pullman Scorpiuses. And, oh, wow, one bite for a 72. The Raptor, the Carno, all that stuff was tamed down that river. That'll take you back out to the ocean, as you can see. So yeah, now you know where we are. I love it what does that. If you look at your map and it says me right there, then you zoom out, it'll still say me. And it stays where it was. Kind of funny. Funny glitch they haven't fixed yet. Oh yeah. We could probably just wander all the way over to that thing. I don't think we have nearly as much stuff as we need. Yeah, Fiomia didn't even get a chance to run away. We do not yet have the stuff that we need to activate the beacon thing yet. You're so good, lady. I want to check these things out real quick. Can you pick these? Yeah, you can. Okay. There used to be a really, really fun spot up north. It was the one I couldn't really determine what it was a second ago. Up in this area. I think it's here. I don't think this is it. It might be here. Actually... Yeah, okay, I remember what this is now. Yeah, so it is this. This area right here in the middle. This is where the little lake is, and the lake had tons and tons of cattails. And you could stand there for hours, picking, and gathering, a ton of... kill them. A ton of fiber. And apparently they thought it was OP. So they nerfed it. I don't think it's anywhere near as effective as it once was. Hey, a dire bear. We don't have one of those yet. What level are you? 32. Good enough to kill. Let's boost your melee again. My level's almost up too. Yeah. It's fantastic because it's 160,000. Bye, dire bear. You give me pelt, don't you? I should probably attack a dire bear and then use my axe to gather pelts from it. Ankylo? What level are you, Ankylo? No, 8. Not I. Level 12. Whoa. That Gallimimus is really moving. I don't know what you're running away from. But I got you. trees. So this route that I'm taking up is actually pretty much the same route that we took down. when we went to Carnivore Island to tame this Rex, we took, let me just go to the map again. We swam across here, point to point, which is kind of frightening because there are megalodons in there, and I set my T-Rex to passive so that it would not attempt to attack them back and would just beeline directly for shore. But T-Rexes aren't very fast swimmers, so it took a long time, and I was worried that they'd just kill it while it was swimming across. It only seemed to take about 1,500 damage away, though, and it was already at 5,000 health at the time, so it wasn't a big deal. And then we just wandered on down this way. Here, and to base. Just all down this river. And it was pretty fast. Pretty peaceful. There wasn't a lot of skirmishes that we got into. That's an interesting first-person view. Is that a Diplo? Diplodocus? Depending on who you ask, Diplodocus? Yeah, I don't know. If any of you know for sure how to pronounce these things, go ahead and try to explain it to me down in the comments. Particularly with, well, what did I just kill? Sabertooth salmon? I've never killed a sabertooth salmon. See all these things here? In case I don't know if I've explained very often, these things will actually show you their dossiers. These things come up with some animals. It's the first time you kill it. With some animals, it's the first time you tame it. And some, it's both. It's like when you tame it or kill it, it comes up for the first time. So sabertooth salmon apparently is one that you have to kill to get it. I don't know what this one is. It's probably something really low level that I haven't tamed yet. Dodos, coelacanth, these are regular fish. Dilophosaurus, little monkeys. So yeah, it's got to be something pretty low level there. And then most of this stuff in here, I have tamed at some point while playing ARK. And so all these dossiers are filled out. All these ones later on are things that I have not yet tamed or killed to get their dossiers. Look, I got the broodmother. But yeah, that's what those are. That's where they come from. Wow. 380 from that one thing. Huh. Oh yeah. Need to give you some more melee. Still want to get you up to 1,000. Are you even at level... What level are you at? 165. I forgot you weren't a perfect tame. I was like, shouldn't you be at like 200 by now? But no, you started out at 149, I think is what your max level was. Ooh, 212. That's unfortunate that I killed it. Oh well. What am I killing now that's getting me so much XP? The higher level things and the larger things tend to give you more XP. I didn't think that I had done something that... Well, I guess maybe it was the trike? That's possible. And I feel like they've updated the graphics on these waterfalls. As I approach one and it looks really funky. I don't know what's going on with that particular waterfall. That looks really weird. Is doing it on that one too? It's just... Whoa, I just killed... Oh yeah, there they are. The little ants on the ground down here. Just walking over them, killed them. And gathered resources from them. That's fantastic. Hey, I need to give more stamina while this guy's attacking me. The Gigantopithecus is just chilling down there. Oh, he's trying to run away now. I don't know why he's running away. I wasn't going to attack him. Yeah, that waterfall's doing the same thing the other one was. Whoa. Huh. Yeah, just that layer of water that's out in front of the waterfall. It looks kind of a little funny when you're at an angle like this. Oh. Doesn't look as funny on this one as it did in the last one. Interesting. Hey, we're almost there. Check it out. Little 16 dodo. Looks like I gotta wander all the way onto the other side. This is one of the really, really annoying things about T-Rexes is their turning radius is abysmal. It looked like it actually turned pretty sharply just then. I wonder if they've changed it. Because it didn't used to turn that sharply. Alright, I'm going to come over to the other side because that one's where the land bridge is. It takes you into the center. Well, look at this battle. Oh, it's Raptor. Some Carnos up ahead. They'll give me something to attack. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, bite, bite, bite. I can see you. I can see you, Carno Raptor. Oh, dang. I got them both in one bite. 1900. Almost full on health. Holy cow, you have so much stuff in your inventory right now. Let's take out all the things that we like and throw away all the things we don't want. Throw that away. Take, take, take. Actually, we don't really want hide. We do want pelt, though. That was our intent in doing this. Seraprod vertebrae, okay. We actually use them as part of the ritual to open up a portal. Let's just get rid of all this hide. I feel so good finally being in a state where I can get rid of hide. Wait, did I already pass it? Where's the bridge? Oh, I haven't gotten to it yet. Come on, turn sharply, turn sharply. Perfect. And then come walking over this way. Oh, there it is. Okay. Looks like you gotta look straight down for it to do a really sharp turn, because otherwise its turns aren't that sharp. These are enormous. Just these plants right here, they're usually like half that tall. That's pretty cool. A snake. Come on, kill the snake. No, don't turn that way. If you're gonna turn that way, you better be quicker about it. Kill the snake. Snakes give me prime meat? I didn't know that. Alright, we're almost there. I hope you guys are enjoying this less ambitious episode. Just me wandering around with Lady, leveling her up. Oh, she has this really weird problem with the back of her knee, too. Whenever she's at, like, an awkward elevation and she stretches out her leg. See if I can do it again. Doesn't look like it's going to do it now because it's a pretty even elevation on the ground I'm standing on. But yeah, when she does that, she like extends her knee beyond a certain limit. You can see through her leg. Yeah, it looks like they've definitely changed these things to all look like this. They didn't used to look like this, much more flat. Like, well, they were flat. They were just elevated. So there was like a platform that was elevated probably at about the height of my vision right now. And there was ramps all along the outside that took you to it. But it looks like they've changed that now. So yeah, you can see I need to get Seraprod vertebrae, Argentavis talons, Tyrannosaurus arms, and Megalodon teeth to the tune of 8442, which is quite a bit. As you can see, I still don't even have as many of these as I need. So yeah, you go out and kill a ton of those to gather all those resources. And then it does one. It opens up a portal now. It didn't used to. This used to only activate the broodmother. And you'd just come here, activate the thing, and the broodmother would just appear right over there and start attacking you. But now I believe they've changed it out. Deposit items to tribute. Oh, transport ARK data. Okay, that's still a thing. Upload survivor data, creature data, download creature data. You can do that here too, so you can save dinosaurs from worlds. Like if you have one single player map or a map that you play with a bunch of friends in PvE, you can save your dinosaurs here and then transfer them to your new world when you want to play with them again in a different world. So it's pretty cool. There's a lot of things you can do here. But yeah, the broodmother would appear and you'd kill it. But now you see this circle here. I think that's the area that it's affected when you activate the tribute. A big dome appears over top of this area and transports everything inside to an arena where you fight either the broodmother or the, I don't even remember what the giant monkey thing is called. King Kong. Oh, you just ate raw fish. I didn't know you'd eat raw fish. Or the big dragon. Smaug. But yeah. I think I'm actually going to end it here because it's already a pretty lengthy episode. I hope you guys enjoyed the travel up here. Let's see. Let me K out. Yeah. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed the trip. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. Well, that's cool. It's hollow down here. That's kind of cool. Yeah, I like that. If you enjoyed the series, be sure to subscribe for more ARK. And we will see you guys in the next episode. Bye.